I work in Angular every day, and I build things that need to be animated or transitioned when interacted with. And because of this, I'm thankful for the animations module. There are so many useful features available that make life much easier. We're going to look at two of these features in this video. First, we're going to use the query function to find and animate several items at once. Then, we'll use the stagger function to create a delay between the animations running on each of these items. All right, let's get to it. Before we get too far along, it's important to note here that I've already created several videos focused on the animation framework. They cover the basics of setting up and using Angular animations, creating state-based and enter-leave animations, and using the keyframes function to create more complex animation sequences. So if any of those concepts are unfamiliar to you, you'll probably want to check those videos out first so that you're not lost in this video. Okay, enough of that. On to the example for this video. Here we have this application listing out some NBA players. At first, we only see LeBron James, but when we click the Add button at the bottom, the list is updated to show the rest of the players from our collection. And when we hit the Remove button, all players but LeBron are removed. This is cool, but the way these items are added and removed is a little lame. It would be better to transition them in and out like this, wouldn't it? Well, this is actually all possible with the Angular Animations module. We're going to start by using the query function to query for all items entering and leaving the DOM to transition them as they do so. The query function expects a selector parameter as a string, then an array of animation metadata, and optionally an options object of animation query options. Okay, let's look at some code. For our list of players, we start with an array of the first player in the list data, LeBron. Then when we hit the Add button, we call this addPlayers function, which will add a bunch more players to the array from our players data. And when we hit the Remove button, we call this removePlayers function to remove all but the first player from the list. Then, in the template, we use a for loop to iterate over the array of player objects to loop out a player component for each player, which displays the data. Now, if we recall from the video I created on enter and leave animations, these items are being added to and removed from the DOM, so we can transition these using the enter and leave aliases. We start by adding our animations array within our component. Then we add an animation trigger with the trigger method. Let's name it animation. Within the array for this trigger, we'll add a transition using the transition method. We're going to bind this animation to our player's array, so when that array data changes, we trigger our animation. This means that for our state, we will need to animate from any state to any state, which we can do with an asterisk, arrows both ways, and then another asterisk. All right, so all of that animation configuration up to this point should be familiar from my previous videos on animations. But now we're going to do something you may not have seen before. We're going to use the query function. This function will query within the element the trigger is placed on for items matching the selector or selectors provided to it. In our case, we're going to add it to the element that contains our for loop. The reason for this is so that we can query for all items being added to the DOM nested within this container using the enter alias. Okay, after providing the selector, we need to provide our animations as an array. First, let's add the style that we'll start from with the style function. Let's start from an opacity of 0 and transform from a scale of 0.7. so the items will start out scaled down and invisible. Then we'll create our transition using the animate method. We'll animate over 500 milliseconds, and we'll use an ease in timing function. Now let's add the style we'll transition to with another style function. We'll end at an opacity of 1 so that it's fully visible, and we'll transform to a scale of 1 so that it's full size. Okay, now let's go into the template and bind the animation trigger onto our div, and we'll use the players field to trigger the animation. Okay, let's save and see how it looks. When we hit the add button now, we can see all the items transition in nicely. That's cool. So we know this animation is properly querying for all items entering and properly transitioning them. Now let's get them animating out on leaves. Let's just copy our enter animation. Now let's query for items leaving with the leave alias. Then we just need to flip the styles that we're animating between. So we'll start with an opacity of 1 and a scale of 1. Then we'll animate to an opacity of 0 and a scale of 0.7. Okay, let's save and try this now. Whoa, it looks like the enter animation is no longer working. And this leave animation is doing some weird stuff too. But there's a reason for this. When using the query function, sometimes there may be no items matching the items you're querying for. And this is the case with our leave animation. On initialization, there's only one thing happening. One item is entering because we have only one list item. There are no items leaving, so we get an error, which we can see if we expand the console. It tells us exactly what's happening and what we need to do to fix it. We just need to add this options object with optional set to true to our queries. Okay, now let's save and try again. Nice. Now our enter animation is working correctly again. And this time our leave animation is working too. But I really don't like how all these items animate in at the same time. I would rather stagger them in and out, and that's exactly what we're going to do next. For this stagger effect, Angular has us covered with the stagger function. This function expects the animation timings as a string, exactly like we're used to with the animate function. And for its second parameter, it expects an array of animation metadata, also like we're used to with the animate function. Okay, so let's add the stagger function to our enter animation. Here we're going to wrap the animation function, so we'll add the stagger function. And the first parameter is the timing to delay the animation. We'll go with 100 milliseconds. Then we have an array, and this will wrap the animation. Okay, let's save and see how it works now. Cool, that's a much nicer effect. I like that a lot better. Okay, now let's stagger them as they leave too. We just need to add the stagger function around our leave animation this time. And we'll keep the 100 millisecond timing to be consistent. Okay, let's save and try this now. Okay, that's cool. It's staggering now, but I'd rather it stagger them out the other way so that the last item to leave is the one at the top instead of it being the first item to leave like it is now. Well, guess what? This is pretty easy to do. We just need to make the timing a negative number. Now, let's save and try this one more time. Nice. Now that seems like the right way to animate those. Okay, so now you know how to query for one to many items to animate, and you know how to stagger them too. So hopefully you found this helpful. Now remember, there's still a lot to the animation framework, so I'll go ahead and stop here for now. But I will be creating several more videos on Angular animations very soon. Until next time, thanks for watching.